Hi, praise Lord. This is Sophie, and you can see my husband Manoj and my son Ivan Samuel. I have a great testimony to share with you all. I've been married in 2013 when I was 25 years old, and soon after marriage, I've been relocated to Bangalore, and we used to come to LIG Church, where I used to meet Pastor Prince and Sister Susan. They are like a family. So like what happened was, soon after my marriage, after 1 year of time, I've been diagnosed with ovarian cancer. So we were like, both of us were like literally shattered. We didn't know what to do, but yes, pastor and family were with us throughout our journey over there. And then actually I've been to Vijayawada for some work of my father's birthday, and unexpectedly I've been diagnosed with stage 2 ovarian cancer. Then without my notice, my husband and my parents, they didn't tell me, but both of my ovaries and fallopian tubes were removed with my husband's consent. And after that, I was being treated with lots of proteins and food. I was asked like, why am I've been treated with lot of food? Then my husband comes and he says slowly that we are preparing you for chemotherapy treatment and your ovaries and tubes have been removed. I was like totally shattered, didn't know what to do. And then for the second opinion for the chemotherapy treatment, we've been to Mumbai. And there, Pastor Prince and Susan, we used to contact them. They used to be always with us on the phone call saying, Manoj, Sophie, what happened? What did doctor say? And yes, Pastor used to say that we release life on you. Nothing to worry, nothing will happen. And then we've been to Mumbai, and there we met the doctor for the chemotherapy drugs to be administered. And then what did doctor say? He said, like, I wanted to retest your fallopian tubules and ovaries.
Which I don't do normally.
Yes.
But looking at us, he wanted to retest the fallopian blocks. So he asked us to get those blocks, what we have in my hometown. So then we have couriered them, and then we have sent them for the retest. And we went back to Mumbai to visit the doctor again. And surprisingly, the reports turn around. And this time it was a borderline cancer. Initially, when she was going through a surgery, it was stated as a stage 2 cancer and she has to go with the chemo. But the next visit, God has turned the reports up and down. So now it's a borderline cancer, and the doctor said, now you don't have to go with the chemo.
And so we were like so joyful. We immediately called Pastor Prince and Susan, and they are like, yes, God has released the life over you. Yeah. Do not worry. So we were like, we came so happily. And what doctor said was, you will not have children by, you know, natural conception because you don't have ovaries and fallopian tubes. So better go adopt a baby or go for artificial insemination and return us to after 2 years, so that we'll remove the uterus as well. So that at least you'll have life to live. So we are like adopting a child, and we're like, no, our God is a creator. He creates the children. Like children are a blessing from God. So we just believed our word. We never returned to that doctor again. Actually, people used to scold us, are you laymen, are you fools, why are you like playing with your lives, why don't you remove your uterus as well? But we are like, no, our God is a creator. So after that, I used to have my regular menstrual cycle again, which normally people do not have. Because women with whom the ovaries and tubes have been removed, they will not have their, you know, regular menses. But I was having the regular bleeding as well. Then I used to visit the doctors, and they were like shocked. They used to tell that, why is this bleeding happening? It might be the remnant blood of the surgery which has been done. So we're like, okay, for the next month and every other consecutive month, I was having my regular period. And they were shocked. They asked me to go for some scans, and they were shocked to know that the ovaries which we removed with our hands has been recreated again. Actually, one ovary, right? Left ovary has been recreated again. They were like shocked. And they're like, okay, Sophie, your ovary has been created. So yes, your ovary is producing eggs, but you don't have fallopian tubes for the egg to travel to the uterus for the baby to conception. So we are like, okay, our God has created an ovary, and I got my own eggs to produce the baby. So we didn't go to that doctor again as well. So we are just switching the doctors. We didn't go. Yes, we used to be in touch with our pastor and the sister Susan. They are like, Sophie and Manoj, we declare life on you. We declare life on you. This is the only word which he used to say us. And yes, they used to say us to have communion, sacrament, every day. Actually, even I don't know the importance of sacrament till then. But when pastors said, we start to believe the importance of the sacrament, and we used to take it almost every day. Not every day, but almost every day. We used to forget. But our Lord Jesus didn't forget us. So what happened then? As usual, we were going to some prayer meeting every Saturday. There a prophet called us and he said, Sophie, you have a good news. At that time, I didn't have my husband with me. He was in US for some meeting.
After 3 years
of all this, we didn't go to any doctor. We didn't go like anywhere. We're just believing, staying calm. People used to scold us. Then he said, look, as soon as your husband come from US, go to the doctor for the checkup. Then I was like, what checkup? And I was like, okay, blindly we believe that God, I think he has blessed us with children. So immediately at that night after he has come, we've been to hospital. And even the doctor who used to see me in Hyderabad, even she got shocked and says, how could this be possible? And she asked us to go with some blood tests, scans and everything. And then she confirmed, like, Sophie, you're 7 weeks pregnant already. Man, this is a great miracle which has changed my life. And even she, I've undergone a lot of test while pregnant. She used to say there might be some abnormality in the baby, look, you need to be careful. Well, we were like, okay. But yes, I was very careful in my pregnancy period. And in 2013, we heard Pastor Prince in the church saying that if you have faith, we can move the mountains, and you just rest and leave it to God. He can do all impossible things in your life which you don't think can be possible. So we were like, okay, so we'll believe for a normal delivery. This is what we believe for an impossible thing, because I've already been undergone a surgery, which is a major cut surgery, and a natural delivery is not possible for me. But even then, doctors there, they didn't allow me for regular normal delivery. But then one of the doctor came and said, we'll try for a regular delivery. And with our prayers being answered, with that miracle, I have a beautiful son today. And it was hardly 5 seconds of delivery, which I didn't have any delivery pains as well. So this was all a beautiful journey which God has given in our life. We have been blessed, so much blessed with the church.
And this is our baby, Ivan Samuel. You can see. So not only this, this church has been a great journey for us in our life, where we have seen greater miracles. One of the miracles is this guy. And we have seen great blessings in our jobs. Pastor Prince has given us so much of strength in our belief to see greater heights in our jobs, in our careers, in our life, in our personal life. So even everything, wherever I go, I carry the same faith, same grace, same blessings I have in my life. So I also preach the same thing to my friends, my colleagues, everyone. So it's been a great journey in our life. And we thank you so much, LIG, for this. And everyone who have been supporting us from the church in our prayers and everything else. I give thanks for Susan and Pastor Prince, especially for being with us and supporting us through all this journey. Thank you so much for this opportunity.
Thank you.